growing up, I didn't always have a whole lot. You know, there were times in the house where we didn't have, you know, a whole lot of food, didn't have, you know, the utilities would get shut off, and we moved around a lot from place to place. And I always promised myself I would not rob God or steal from God when it came time for my turn to be able to make those decisions for myself. And when I came back to the Lord and I started going to the men's home, I actually put in a pass because I found out that it was not automatically coming out of my income. I put in a pass to be able to tithe normally. Since I started giving, the Lord has allowed me to start a business. I own some homes and things like that, and am a landlord. I work in the IT field, and the Lord's blessed that as well. And none of it would have been possible had I thought or had I assumed that it was my income, my money, and was selfish with it. God gave me the ability to do those things. He allowed me to work in those fields, and has been very merciful and gracious in my life. Without his leading and without his word, I would not be where I am today. God's used all of that stuff to bless me very richly in my life. And it came with an understanding that, just like other people have said, that it's all God's money anyway. When I die and go to heaven, I'm not taking any of this trivial stuff with me, and I'll be much more richly rewarded in heaven for the things that I've done for the Lord. So God allows me to keep a tiny, tiny fraction of what's His in this world in my bank account, and He lets me call it mine. And I'm very grateful to God for what He's given me. And it makes it easier and easier to be able to give back a little bit of what's already His back to Him.